Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to...
G'day, and welcome back to the Between Bread Show. If you are new around here, we take parts from people's history, their favourite food, and their contribution to food culture, and put it all between bread and see how they taste. So, let's make an Andrew Ray. Andrew was born in Mendon in New York, and while I couldn't find any food that Mendon was specifically known for, I did find an old menu for the Cottage Hotel that was established in 1822. On the menu, I saw they were doing an appetizer of a chicken lettuce wrap with a spicy soy sauce, so thought let's start there. Into a bowl, we'll add 1/4 cup of soy sauce, 2 tablespoons of sesame oil, 1 tablespoon of rice wine vinegar, 2 teaspoons of chili oil, and 1.5 teaspoons of grated ginger. With our spicy soy sauce all made up, the other components from this that we'll use are the lettuce, scallions, and jalapenos, all of which we can add later. So I couldn't find anywhere where Andrew said what his favorite food is. However, I did find an interview where he said his favorite foods to order of a weekend are Alla Norcina or a Parm Hero. So let's incorporate both. Starting out with the chicken schnitzel component. For this, I've got a large chicken breast, which I'm gonna butterfly and then continue to cut in half. And then we've got our breading stations. One plate has flour seasoned with salt, the other has eggs, and the last I used a combination of breadcrumbs and panko breadcrumbs. Doing this ensures we get a great mix of both bigger crunchy bits and smaller crunchy bits. It's just really good. Starting off by dusting our chicken with the flour, then into our egg wash, trying to utilize the wet hand, dry hand method before just completely giving up and sanding in your hands. After all our chicken is breaded, it gets dropped into hot oil set to 375 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is 190 Celsius. For chicken this thick, I would say allow 3 to 4 minutes for cooking on each side. Or, you know me, grab your temperature probe and stick the thickest part of the thickest bit of chicken. Once it reads 165F or 75C, your chicken is good to come off and wait on a wire rack. And if we have a quick look at our work, we can see the chicken looks very... Ooh, that definitely didn't land on the ground. Just pop that back on the plate. Now, before we get onto the sauce for the Parm Hero, I'd like to take this moment to apologize to all Italians who may be watching this, because we're not making a red sauce. This is where we're going to instead incorporate our Alla Norcina sauce. So let's make it. To begin, into a large saucepan, add a generous amount of olive oil. Once that's up to a medium heat, in comes 1 medium diced onion, saute the onions for a couple of minutes until translucent and fragrant, and then we're going to add 2 crushed garlic cloves. Now we want these to get a couple of minutes in the pan as well, so you may have to reduce your heat or add a little bit of water to stop them from burning. While that does its thing, let's prepare our Italian pork sausages. You'll need 250 grams or about 3 sausages worth, and remove the skins. To do this, slide your knife down one side and simply peel the skin off. Once our sausages are naked, they are ready for the pan. You can try and break them apart prior if you like, but as you can see, that is not very easy to do. It's better to get them in the pan, get some heat into them, and then using a wooden spoon, break them apart. Once our sausage meat is cooked through, we will deglaze with 1/2 glass of white wine. And then once that has reduced and the boozy smell is all but gone, we'll add 200 milliliters or 6.5 ounces of heavy cream. We're gonna let this cook for another 2 to 3 minutes and let it reduce and thicken up, seasoning with salt and freshly ground black pepper. Now, if I had a friend over and I could afford to, this is where I would grate in 1 black truffle. However, I'm not and I can't, so we're gonna skip that step. With that all done, let's assemble this cross-continental catastrophe, the first iteration of which turned out to be a soupy mess. The main mistakes that were made were: I toasted the schnitzel and cheese in the bun. I added too much Alla Norcina sauce. Then I put the salad on top of the saucy mess, completely hiding the chicken and making for a very ugly sandwich. The family then proceeded to eat the rest of the ingredients, forcing me to make all of it again the following night. For our second assembly, we dope the top and bottom bun of an Italian sub roll with truffle aioli, then toast the buns and the chicken separately. This meant when it came time to assemble, we could lay down some protective sheets of lettuce, followed by our jalapenos, scallions, and alfalfa sprouts, cover that in our spicy soy sauce, our chicken, then our Alla Norcina, and that is it. Now this looks a lot prettier than the other version, and to be honest, the balance of flavors is better. But what did it taste like? The tastes are hard to describe. It's very good. It is very, very good. And I made all of these things again separately after this shoot. Do they work together? Surprisingly, yes, they did. Should they be together? No. This is the only reason to make this sandwich. I encourage you to definitely make the spicy chili. Definitely make some Alla Norcina. The Alla Norcina Parm Hero could definitely be a thing. That was super dope. Will I make this again for myself in private? No, definitely no. Goodbye.